All right. So, Castleigh, let's just start from the basics. What is your credit score at its base? You know, we all have these numbers. We all kind of understand what these numbers are to a certain extent. Yeah. But let's start with the very, very basics, because I think there's a lot that can be learned if you understand fundamentally what something is. So fundamentally, what is your credit score?
So your credit score is really a third party indicator of financial past responsibility. That's typically what it is. All right, so let me try to simple that down. So I don't know you. I'm going to give you access to money, typically a loan, credit. How do I get some type of comfort level with the chances of you paying me back, right? You honoring this financial contract. And that's literally what the credit score's main basis is for, is for lenders, creditors who are giving access to services or capital to people who say, hey, I don't know Tom, you know, Jim and Lawrence. What's kind of their, what's their past history or past financial responsibility been that's going to give me comfort to know that they're going to kind of, you know, honor my contract and pay me back. So that's what they're kind of, that's the essence of what they're trying to calculate. Based on 800 credit score, high probability you'll get your money back, 99.3%. And there's a lot of data behind it. So what they end up doing is looking at a lot of past payment history data for the general population and saying, based on these kind of characteristics, and that's kind of what the information that's in your credit score, I mean, your credit report, based on this data compared to the general population and all these other people that have done certain things and it reflects certain pieces of your information, what's the likelihood that you're going to pay me back? So that 700 credit score is attached to a delinquency score. And that's when that you don't pay somebody back. So the higher the delinquency score or relative is, the lower your credit score is going to be. So for example, somebody has like an 800 plus credit score, very low delinquency. You're talking about like 0.2%, 0.5% of chances that you miss a payment in the next like 24 to 36 months, right? Mm-hmm. Low risk. I'm good with lending Lawrence money. Lawrence 800, cool. There's a very low probability you're not going to pay me back, right? Mm-hmm. With this 2%, 4% interest. That's why I also lend you pretty low, because you're pretty good at paying people back. Cool, rock with me. Now, when you got like a 550, 600 credit score, you might not pay me back pretty high. So you're probably looking at somewhere near like a 25% delinquency rate, right? 30% delinquency rate, depending on the products. And another piece is that delinquency rates go by product. Product being car loans, student loans, credit cards, mortgages. So there are actually credit scores for each of those products. What, so the average person, what they don't realize is that you actually are walking around with like about 50 to 60 different credit scores. Because each of the bureaus calculates a score, but then there's all the products that there are that you potentially get a credit score for, right? So you're like, you have actually an auto insurance credit score.
Right. I didn't know that. Okay.
So, but the one that people typically get on their Credit Karma or even on our app is your general obligation score. Right. So you have this general obligation score, which is kind of, it's close. Now the credit scores, all these different credit scores are within some type of variance. So you're not going to see somebody has an 800 on one and a 600 on the other one. They're usually within some type of range. Right. So the game is like, how do you make sure that your credit score in your report reflects the best of you? Because that's really what it comes down to. I don't know you. Same way when you apply to a job, right? You send your resume in, you put your GPA on there, especially when you graduate into school, your resume and your GPA is what is going to kind of make or break you. Same way with you applying for a loan. You do it through these systems or you go to a bank, they look at your credit score, they look at your report and say, hey, based on this data, what's the chances this person is going to actually pay me back?
That's gotcha. It. Yeah, no, I love it. And, you know, if we put some numbers to it, I don't know if you know these numbers or not. So you mentioned the delinquency rate of someone who has a 550, 600 credit score. What is the median credit score in the United States? And then what's the delinquency rate associated with that credit score, if you know?
The median is about 700 right now. I think between 7 and 705.
Okay, so between 7 and 705. And
delinquency rates on those are relatively low. I think they're about between 5 and 7%.
Okay, got you. So someone, an average person, you know, 5 to 7% of them, or a median person, whatever, Between 5 and 7% of those people will be delinquent.
Delinquent within the next 36 months or so. That's kind of closely what they're trying to get to. But then you have subsegments of those scores. And this is mm-hmm. where, unfortunately, Black and brown people come in. So mm-hmm. the 700 is par, is prime, right? Mm-hmm. So 700 is about average, it's prime rate. I mean, it's a prime number. The average for the other folks that look like us is around 650, 660. So you're subprime or near subprime. So those delinquencies are like 17%.
Got you. So, you know, those delinquencies go up, you know, when you get down to, you know, that type of level.
It spikes a lot. That's another way, reason why banks typically don't like to lend in that 650, 620, 650 range, because the delinquencies don't match. They're much further off from like a 700. 700, you have a 5% chance. All right, cool. I can compensate with that with a little bit higher interest rate. But you're looking at, you know, 17, 18% chance, much higher probability you're going to kind of miss a payment and end up in, you know, cost of recovery. So now I'm going to end up with this bad loan in collections. I'm going to sell it off, end up going through that whole write-off process. It becomes a lot more cumbersome, and you know, there are real implications, much realer implications to the banks. So that's why a lot of traditional banks don't really like to play in that subprime space.